Hello everyone, this is Hawk the Hedgehog Fan 001 here today with more Super Smash Bros. Project Legacy. Now we're going to go get into some of the characters that I kind of play with a little bit more. So, Falco's is still the same. Side, down tilt, side tilt, up tilt. Neutral air, up air. Back air, down air, which still spikes pretty well, and then forward air, which is the same as Fox's. So neutral B has a hit stun. Down B is different because it's more based off of melee. This Falco is more based off of melee, actually, because that doesn't get kicked out. That still stuns. That still does the spike, but you still have this too, so this Falco is more based off of melee. Yeah, because you don't have him doing his wing attack, so that's his up tilt. Okay, so that's still the same. I did the air attacks, back air, up air, down air. Oh yeah, dash attack is still the same. Down tilt, forward tilt, up tilt, I've already done. Neutral B, down B. Side B, up B, which still doesn't get far, but I still think it does the multi-hit thing like Lucas. Let me see if I can get off. Or does it? No, it's a single-hit attack, which is new. Wrong thing. So that's still the same, and now I'm gonna go ahead and kill myself to show off the taunts and stuff. Okay, so now I'm gonna show off the taunts. And end it here. Piece of cake. Don't try it. Hands off my prey. Or as the meme goes, hands off my bread. Because he's a bird. Okay, so next we're going to go into Fox. So his new moveset is normal. Forward tilt, down tilt, up tilt, dash attack. Neutral air, up air, back air, forward air, down air, which is a multi-hit move. It kind of barely spikes, not really, but a little bit enough to gimp. So his neutral B obviously is the same, side B is the same, up B is the same, down B is the same. Charge attack. Down charge, up charge. His charge attacks are all the same. I get all the B attacks, all the tilts. Yeah, I did the air text. Okay. Taunts? So, his is all the same. I didn't do the tilts for Falco, so I'll go back and do those. Oh. Oh, come on. There we go. So his is still the same. And that's pretty much it. So we do Falco's charge attacks. And I'll show off all the costumes, like if it's a series, after I'm done showing off the characters in the series. So yeah, Falco is more based off of a melee in this because he has the same. His up B doesn't have as much knockback as Fox's, not at all. So, Falco costumes, there's that one, this one. And then you have the different melee costumes as well. And that's pretty much it for Falco. For Fox, we have that one. We have a wolf outfit, that outfit, green. We have his dad. Then we also have the melee outfits. And now I'm going to move on to Wolf. Wolf actually plays really well in this. I was surprised. So most of his stuff is still the same. Tilts are still the same. Neutral air is still the same. Forward air. Up air. Down air. Back airs. So the air attacks are still the same. Most pretty much just tilts and stuff, but his charge attack is, dash attack is different. It's a one hit move, but it does still go in the air. Next we have the V attacks, still reflector, still multi-hit attack for Wolf. Neutral B is still, oh, That didn't hit as much as I thought it would. Side B. Okay, so it more like just hits a lot on the way. So side B is still the same. It critical hits at the top where you hit. Kind of like Sonic does in Smash Slash 2. Down B still does damage. Obviously. Up B, once again, you don't get much movement after you're done doing it. You just get the movement of it. Taunts. So taunts are still the same, actually. Oh yeah, charge attacks. I'll do those in a moment. Because one of his charge attacks is actually different. Forward charge is the same, down charge is the same. Up charge is different. Uses his claws. That's not what I want to do. Sorry, I am a bit tired. Are you kidding me with this bullcrap? Obviously still the Red Lamp Master. And then the different outfits. You got a red one. You got a cool looking one right here. He looks more like a wolf. An actual wolf. Blue one, which is pretty cool. The white one. And then you've got this one, which I think is from Star Fox 64. I'm not sure if he was even in that one, because I haven't played that one. But the outfits are really cool, and that's about it. So next are the Zelda series. We're gonna start with Zelda herself. So the down B are gonna be different because you can't change into Sheik. Aha. So neutral is still the same, down tilt's the same. That's the dash attack. Forward tilt, up tilt. Down air, neutral air, forward air, back air, up air. Once again, each of those pretty much has a critical hit point. So dash attack, obviously. Down charge, up charge, side charge. Neutral B, side B. Okay, never mind. The down B still switches between them. Up B still moves you. Okay, so, and then I'm only gonna show this off, the smash off for hers, because hers and Sheik's are the exact same smash. Like the exact same. They pull out a light arrow and shoot the opponent. And it's pretty much an instant kill. Oh, taunts, duh. One. Two. So they added a cool little sound effect for that. Probably like her calling out to Link or something. Okay, now for Sheik. So once again, I'm not going to do the final smash because it's the same. So that's the same. That was dash attack. Tilts. Up charge. Side charge. Down charge. Neutral air. Up air. Back air. Forward air. Down air, which has which gets a spike, but you don't have to worry about quick falling. It's really hard to get, but when you get it, I think you have to be directly over the person. There we go. Yeah, you have to be directly over him, or like a little bit in front of him. Neutral B. Okay, so you have to hold it. And she can't hold on to him as soon as you let go of the button. He lets him go. So, side B is the cable, which you can still move around. Down B still changes, sadly. Up B. And that's pretty much it. Taunts. So I'm going to show off the different costumes for them now. Nice little red, blue, different color outfits and stuff. Then you have different forms of Zelda through the games. And that's pretty much it for Zelda. Sheik has just mostly different colored stuff. Nice little colorations and stuff. That's pretty much it. Now for Link. So he still has this for melee. And if you hold off on it long enough, you can do the normal attack from Brawl and Fort. Down tilt, forward tilt, up tilt, dash attack. Neutral air, up air, come on, down air, forward air, back air, charge attacks, forward charge, down charge, up charge, neutral B, normal arrow, gale boomerang, but it doesn't really bring a gale, it's just a multi-hit, and then bomb. I think it just is a multi-hit. Come on. Yeah, it's a multi-hit, but for some reason it's not. Okay, so it's not the Gale Boomerang. I think there's one that does give you a Gale Boomerang, but I'm not sure. But anyway, that's pretty much it. So, taunts are pretty much the same except for this one. That one's from Melee, where he brushes his hair back. I think it is. Final smash. Puts you in the Triforce, and there is no escape. Okay, so now we're on to Toon Link, who also has a different moveset, but his is majorly different. And I kind of like it. I like what they did with most of the moveset, but this, it leaves it up for combo potential. A lot of combo potential. I hate that they changed the charge attack. I mean, the dash attack. The dash attack feels so weird in this. The tilt attack is still the same. Up tilt. Down. Down tilt is different, though. I kind of like that. I do like it a lot. Up air. I like the down air because it doesn't force you down. It's like normal length. Forward air. Back air. Neutral air. So, up charge. Down charge still gets both of them, and the forward charge, boom. It's that one hit, and it looks and feels really good, actually. So, he and Link obviously still have that. So that taunt is different. So that's pretty much it. Down B. Down B. Normal bomb. There's something different about his arrows, though. He gets fire arrows. Then his up B, Link's up B, I forgot to kind of show off, but Link's up B is an instant. You can't hold and charge. It's just an instant happening. Toon Links you can kind of... Toon Links you can charge though. Toon Links you can charge because it's kind of like a multi-hit. But you cannot charge... you cannot charge the normal Links. Okay, so I can't really grab him from me. So we did taunts. We got one more thing left to do. Yeah, Ike. Today is your day of reckoning. Okay, so the different costumes. Link has that. He's got one where he's at, like, his training camp. I think that's from Skyward Sword, but I don't know. You've got that one, which is from, one of the newer games. I can't remember what it's called, but it's actually really fun. It's kind of like an open battlefield area with different objectives that you're given. Then you have Majora's Mask, Deity Link. And then you have Kid Link. Kid Link. And then Dark Kid Link. I think you have a normal Dark Link. No, you don't have a normal Dark Link. But you do have this. Hold on. I wonder if you get the Gale Boomerang with him. Let me see. If you do get the Gale Boomerang, I'll put it down. No, you do not get the Gale Boomerang, sadly. Maybe it's with him. If it's not him, then he doesn't get it. Yeah, he doesn't get the Gale Boomerang, sadly. But still, nice detail. So Toon Link's different ones. He gets a lot of ones, especially one that's kind of a tribute to the GBA. He's got the normal ones. He's got a cool one right there that's a bit different. That's kind of to the classic original. You've got Dark Toon Link. You've got Kid Toon Link in different outfits. And this one's the homage to the GBA, because you have the yellow costume, which is from one. You've got the mirror shield, which is from another. And then you're back to him. So now we're on to Ganon, who plays really well too. And he has a different moveset than the normal Project M Ganon as well. So you've got that, which is extremely fast. That. His forward tilt, which you can... do that with his up tilt is extremely fast. I haven't really gotten to see what it does to people. Oh! That is really powerful. Okay, so down charge. I wonder if it still grasps him. Okay, so charge attack. Okay, so it still does grab him. Then, for some reason, he gets a double. Probably because this is based a little bit off of melee as well, but his are really powerful kicks. So there's a charge. Oh, there's another charge attack that I'm gonna hold off for later because it kind of replaced his neutral B. So we got up air, down air, forward air, back air, which is kind of cool, and neutral air. Now we've got B attacks. Side B, down B, up B. Now we've got neutral B, which is a cape attack. It's pretty much just kind of like a... I don't know if it reflects items or not. I have yet to see if it does. But then we've got his last one. As he pulls out his one hand, which replaces his Ganon punch. Because I'm about to show you all how much damage this does on full charge. Does 30 damage. And just the sheer knockback of this. Just the sheer knockback is that of a Ganon punch. So now for the taunts, get over here. So that's still normal. Ganon also has kind of like a third neutral beat. His last taunt. His last taunt is the one where he pulls out his sword. And this one is really cool. So you have it to where he pulls out his sword. Now if you hold it, you've got your neutral B right there. So your taunt inevitably takes the place of your neutral B in this scenario. So, that's Ganon. He's awesome. And his smash is the same as Brawl, but I'll go ahead and show it off. Maybe. Now we got that. Now to show off his different costumes. Got kind of like clown one, a blue one, green, and a weird cool skull one. Then we've got kind of like the melee Ganon, which is pretty cool. And that's it. Now we're going to go ahead and go into the... Excuse me, Metroid series. Pokemon Mother and Sonic are all going to be in the same episode. Ah. So neutral is the same. Tilts are the same. Charge attacks are still the same. I think Samus literally just plays the same, but she feels a little bit different when she plays. Like, she actually feels a little bit more smooth, if that makes any sense. Up B. Down B. Side B, which you can switch between. You can switch it, but I don't remember how. There it is. You have to press up to switch it to the other one. Up and side at the same time. And neutral B is still the same. So that taunt is a bit different. That taunt is a bit different. Oh, so you can hold the 2 button for a little bit different reaction. Or you can hold that one. So her neutral B is the same, but when she's done, she just stays Samus. She does the huge beam. Obviously, I'm going to need to showcase otherwise people are going to get a little upset. And for the people who don't care, just skip ahead to where Zero Suit is. Unless you want to watch this. To see what on earth happens, because... pretty much the same thing. And then when it's done, she goes down, but she pops back up like nothing happened. Which is cool, because I kind of like this, because now it feels more like 4 a little bit for her. And for Zero Suit. So all of her charge attacks the same. Neutral air. Okay, so her down air is a bit different because it's kind of like Ness's in a way. And she can also bounce off them. See? So you can kind of combo into a double spike. If I can do it quicker. I'd probably have to be outside, but I think you can combo into like a double spike. But that's pretty much everything. B attacks. Oh, cool. Oh, so hold on, let's zoom out for that, because up B is still the same, but... So you can actually angle the down B to any way you want it, so it's very similar to Smash 4. That is awesome. I like that a lot, that's really cool, it gives her an extra jump pretty much. Okay, so taunts. Is that all? Try me. And then oh my. So hers is the same as Flat Smash Slash 2. She just gathers character and launches them. Pretty far too. Because as you can see, he couldn't recover. So, finish with that. So, the alternate costumes for these. For Samus, you have an ice, dark. You got this one, this one. That one, which is pretty cool. Cool. A lot of these costumes are pretty awesome, too. And I'll probably be playing as Samus because of the costumes. Alright, so you had your fanfare there. We got time for like one more. Let's see. Ah, Pit. I can show off Pit. Because I think he plays a little bit different too. Okay, so yeah, you still have the same thing with Link. You can do... It gives you the option, which I like. You can choose to do this, or you can... choose to hold off that extra like half second and do that. Down charge is the same, up charge is the same. Oh! So side charge is what I was thinking for Pit. So if you hold it once, you only have to do it once, but if you press the button again, you can do it a second time. That's an awesome thing that I wish they would have added in Smash 4. Down tilt, same, forward tilt, up tilt, all the same. Neutral air. Up air, back air, down air, forward air. Charge sets. Oh, wait, I went over those. Taunt. Fight is on, you're not ready yet. I mean, that. So, neutral B. So, obviously, you can still direct that. You can still direct the arrows, So the side B is a glide, which is cool. And you can glide and jump out of it, which is awesome. So your up B is you pulling up your shield. And then your down B is still your reflecting shield, which is awesome. So your final smash, I wonder if it's different. Okay, seriously, what the heck is this game's problem? What the... Are you kidding me? Are you flipping kidding me? I have limited time, thank you. Okay, so it's still him asking Palutena for help. So that's pretty much it for Pit, and that's it for now. So I will be posting these up probably sometime later. That's why I haven't had probably something posted yesterday or whenever, but hope you enjoy, and I'll see you all next time. Bye.